Okay, this is a quick intro for the Shure EJ07. This is a tribrid. It is the new version of the EJ07, but it's got an additional balanced armature driver. The original one was four EST drivers in the treble, two BAs in the mid, and one dynamic driver in the low end. This has added a balanced armature to the mids, so far as I can tell. I don't know what the crossover points are. Comes with a decent cable. This one is 4.4, which is fine. I'll probably be switching it to something else. The packaging is rather Spartan. The price is a little bit high. It's got a logo on it. We'll go ahead and start listening to some music since this is music gear. And that's what it looks like. Okay, this is the bass. I've listened to lots of stuff. Massive Attack, Marvin Gaye, Violent Femmes, Led Zeppelin, Eurythmics, listening to different low-frequency instruments, kick drums, bass guitars, synthesizers, lots of stuff. The 808 Roland in the Marvin Gaye track. For this evaluation, one is going to be In Bloom by Nirvana. The other is going to be For Whom the Bell Tolls by Metallica. And the other is When the Levee Breaks. Nirvana In Bloom is the great bass line. For Whom the Bell Tolls is also another great bass line, and also drums. And When the Levee Breaks is the authoritative kick drum. The sample that I'm going to play for you that I listened to is Nirvana In Bloom. Love the bass on this. And here we go. I actually find that to be a better replay than the EJ07 because the bass sounds more balanced, so that bass guitar actually sounds better. Listening to When the Levee Breaks, the authoritative kick drum is authoritative as it should be. That's not a given. Flat bass on something like The Blessing 2, you think it should be accurate. It's not. It sounds normal where it's supposed to be an emphasized kick drum. Tupac and other things, the bass drop sounded fine. Kill Jill, it hit the lowest note, so the dynamic driver is doing its work. In the bass region, their EJ09 has no problem, and it's preferable to the EJ07. And that is the bass. Okay, mid-frequency. Let's take a look at that graph real quick one more time. Again, these are doing mids in a slightly different way, but they're you're kind of doing like this. One is not really better than the other, and one is not dinging or damaging the perception of mids or overemphasizing the gain for vocals. Neither one of them is kind of stepping wrong. Three things that I used to really evaluate. One would be Fleetwood Mac, Secondhand News and Dreams, because they've got male and female vocalists in that. I'm really focusing on that. The quality of that can, depending on the quality of the mids, be quite obvious. It sounded actually quite good on this. Also, In Bloom, again, I did that because that bass line is coming in and it overlaps with Kurt Cobain. And I've heard it on some gear sound kind of crappy when it's getting to that spot. And it's a pretty good evaluation listening to some of the stuff that I listened to today to think, should I carry that on? Because other tracks like the Doobie Brothers, Taking It to the Street, same effect, a bass line, and then it overlaps to the lead vocalist, and sometimes it can cause kind of problems because you've got a low-frequency instrument going on in the same space on the spectrum as the vocalist's fundamentals, and it can get a little bit messy sometimes. This set does that fine. 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover is the sample I'm going to play. I love Paul Simon's voice. It's very smooth. There's little subtleties going on in this portion right here. I thought that this played it actually quite well. Let me go ahead and listen to this real quick.
She said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe in the morning you begin to see the light. And then she kissed me And I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover.
God damn, I love that track. The mids on this are excellent. I did a wiki check on this before, and there's somebody that's got, I think, like a tambourine or something. You can hear it shaking in the background. Sounds so. The little nuances and the subtleties on that track actually sound quite good. And again, Kurt Cobain's vocals for In Bloom also actually sound excellent, even when the bass is playing at the same time. There's no sense of diminished quality of Kurt's vocals. And again, the vocals in Fleetwood Mac sounded good. The mids are fine on this. They're not set back too much, and they're not too forward, and there's no anomaly. There's nothing to really talk about. It sounds good. It was an excuse to play Paul Simon. So, win. And that's the mids. Okay, the treble. Pink Floyd, Money. Boston, More Than a Feeling. Metallica, Fade to Black. ELO, Telephone Line. Pimp C coming up. I see you, Pimp, right there. Boom. Actually, it's from this one right here. For this set, I really focused on Hey, Hey, What Can I Do? A bonus track from the Coda album. Do You Feel Like We Do? Peter Frampton live. I'm going to use that as the sample because of the crowd and the audience, the guitar solo. It's just nuts. There's so much info up in the upper region. Van Halen, Eruption, which transfers into You Really Got Me, is another thing I listen to. The treble sounds great. I think I just became so accustomed to the EJ07. If you really like more treble than that, this is similar to the EJ07 and has more treble. So this might be right at you. The asking price is going to be the thing that becomes, are you cool with that? And the sample that I'm going to do is going to be the Peter Frampton one. Here we go. Okay. Where the hell is my Peter Frampton? Gotta find it. Update my library. Move it. Migration. That's the treble. I'll go ahead and kill this here and give my conclusions. There's my little video on Twitter right there if you want to get a closer look. I'm sorry, that's the EJ07. This is the EJ09. This is a different version. This is the Chinese version that's released in China, but you can probably get it if you quest it. It has even more treble. This comes down to, is it worth the money for you? And it's expensive. The bass is fine. It's actually better than the EJ07. The mids are great. It's equal to the EJ07, in my opinion. The treble is different. It depends on your preference. Is that worth the investment for you? I can't say. I'm happy with the EJ07, and I'm glad I got them in custom. I think this is a really good set. It depends on the size of your wallet. That's really what it comes down to. So I'm not going to put a green check mark next to this video. It's not a bad set by any means. It needs to be compared with some other stuff in its price range, like the MEST, etc. However, I don't think that that's going to turn out. Well, I'll do it. But in conclusion, wait maybe for more impressions. I can't throw a green check or a diamond next to this one. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just expensive. And that's the biggest ding. And that's a big ding for a lot of people. And I'm out. I went from standing on the corner selling cocaine to ripping shows live on stage with hoes yelling my name. To be precise, ripping mics is the light of my life. You fronting like you try for never pull the heist. Ice in my ice is sky high. I'm a fly guy, that's every thug's dream. I really love dream, it's in my bloodstream.